我話開始啊！咁咧，針對一啲近日咧網上起底嘅行為啦，咁用一啲方法去到獲取同埋披露警務人員嘅私隱嘅，而擺上網上啦，同埋一啲咧去攻擊警察網站嘅行為啦，亦都係一啲網上煽動其他人咧去做一啲損毀嘅行為啦。咁網罪科咧喺琴晚咧就作出咗一個行動啦。咁喺今次嘅拘捕行動裏面咧，我哋喺港九新界咧就唔同嘅地方咧就去到拘捕一啲人士嘅。咁我哋現時咧係拘捕咗總共8名人士啦，包括8男2女，年齡介乎咧係16歲至到40歲嘅。咁咧佢哋咧係涉嫌咧係一啲不誠實取用電腦嘅罪啦，未經同意之下披露個人資料啦，刑事毀壞啦，同埋去威嚇去刑事毀壞嘅罪名嘅。我哋行動咧仲係進行中啦，警方咧係唔排除咧係會進一步會拘捕更多人嘅。警方咧強烈譴責喺網上嘅違法行為嘅，網絡世界咧唔係無法可依嘅，大部分咧。在現實世界用到的法例呢，在網上世界呢也都是適合用的。多謝。
我想問其實是15個還是8個，因為剛才開始說8個。
是8個人士啦，包括6男2女的。
Superintendent, can you tell us more about the crimes that they're suspected of? And doxing has long been a problem of cyberbullying, and there has long been criticism that the law isn't doing enough to protect people. So can you tell us more about the numbers of prosecution over doxing in Hong Kong compared to this case?
The operation that we have mounted relates to the ongoing online doxing and the unlawful disclosure of personal data sought from the internet, which resulted, it affected a lot of large number of officers, resulting not only to users but threats. During the operation, CSTCB has arrested 8 persons so far, including 6 males and 2 females. And the operation is ongoing, and we will not. We may actually arrest more people in the future.
我想問下，你而家有幾多個警員係有，即係究竟個規模係有幾大咧？個起底，同埋係用咩方法去揾到呢一啲起底嘅人？同埋即係怕唔怕會有一個嘅防治派？即係啲人係咪可以喺網上面去討論咧？
我哋咧網罪科咧係設立咗一條24小時嘅熱線啦。咁我哋暫時咧係有超過800名嘅同事咧係向我哋舉報嘅。咁我哋亦都係轉介咗去私隱專員公署啦。咁就有150個個案嘅。
可唔可以解釋下佢哋具體即係所指涉及刑事罪行嘅行為到底係乜嘢？即係如果純粹係喺網上披露警員資料，本身其實佢違反咗邊條法例？但係我哋講咗啲乜嘢？
我剛才講起底嗰樣嘢先啦。咁其實咧係未經呢個使用者嘅同意咧去披露一啲個人資料咧，係一個刑事罪行嚟嘅咁樣。咁我亦都講到咧，有啲係攻擊警察網站嗰啲行為啦，咁嗰啲係刑事毀壞嚟嘅。咁亦都係一啲煽動嘅行為啦，咁包括用一啲言語，譬如言語上高係講出一啲非法嘅行為，例如去傷害一啲人嘅身體啊或者財物咁等等嘅呢啲行為。
阿 Sir， 呢8個男女咧係涉及，即係有幾多警員係受到即係起底呢個？
嗱，具體我哋仲係調查中啦。咁但係呢8個人我哋拘捕咧，都直接同我頭先講呢幾條罪行咧係有關係
嘅。首先，警隊嘅網站有冇被成功入侵過咧？我都知。
我哋咧就偵測到有有人咧去嘗試攻擊警察網站啦，但係係唔成功嘅咁樣。
Can you tell us more about the cyber attacks that you arrested those people for? And also, I was asking the problem of doxing. There has long been complaints of doxing. There isn't enough legal protection. So can you give us more numbers on arrests made on doxing?
Your first question is regarding the kind of cyber attacks. The cyber attacks specifically is kind of DDoS attack. distributed denial of service attack targeted at police websites. Regarding the legal issues, I would only say that if someone, online, conduct doxing activities and it disclose personal data, it might, it could contravene the laws of Hong Kong, which is, the unlawful without consent, you distribute people's personal data. 私隱，即係佢講緊嘅身份證號碼啦，甚至乎係講緊屋企人嘅全名啦，屋企人嘅依個身份證號碼啦，出生日期啦咁樣。
阿 Sir， 除咗
同埋亦都有啲住址啊，
有冇除咗警方個網站或者警員之外咧？而家網上都有啲人話咧，起下其他啲人底咧。咁警方會追查呢方面嘅咧？
我頭先所講啦，就所有刑事案件咧，警察咧都係會有責任去查啦咁樣。咁我講緊嘅就係話網上起底嘅咧，其實就係如果你起底而去披露嘅咧，而冇受到人哋即係一個使用者去到嘅同意咧，其實都有機會係觸犯法例嘅。
除咗警方之外，有冇市民投訴過咧，或者向你哋報案
咧？或者今日咧係出嚟咧係講我哋今次行動裏面嘅嘢啦。行動以外嘅嘢咧，我可能冇咁嘅資料。如果你有需要，開問公。
我想知警方網站嗰度，佢哋用乜嘢嘅方式去攻擊警方？
剛才我講嗰種網絡攻擊是 DDoS 啊、CDOS 啊，咁係一啲分段式阻斷服務嘅一種攻擊嚟嘅。
另外喺7月1號之後咧，到而家你哋拉咗幾多人啊？除咗呢八個之外，有冇再有統計咧？即係除咗喺網上，其他有冇拉咗幾多？
嗱，我哋行動仍然進行中啦。咁我哋唔排除咧，我哋會稍後時間。
唔係，即係除咗網上嘅罪行，其他有冇話示威者啊，或者啲其他？我哋而家暫時拉咗幾多人？
今次嘅行動裏面涉及嘅咧，係我哋講緊網上嘅犯罪行為咧。
Any officers requiring protection or facing threats because of the revelation of their details? And can you also walk us through the details that they were revealed?
I do not want to get into too much of the details as the operation is ongoing, but the doxing and the threats that the officers face include constant nuisance calls, someone sending threatening message, including telling them that they will die immediately, including their families and things. Not just the officers themselves, but the family has also received similar messages. People visiting the family members who are working, conducting their daily work and trying to threaten them, all right?
用不誠實使用電腦罪啦，咁啊，而家仲可以用呢條罪咩？
嗰啲警方咧係收到啲乜嘢嘅信息啦，同埋其實而家即係好多人都會喺網上討論，咁會唔會怕造成一個即係寒蟬效應咁樣，令大家係可以？
你第一個問題 ，sorry，
第一個問題係即係警方即係俾人起底嘅警員係攞到即係收到乜嘢嘅信息啊？
我頭先可能已經問到，都講我再講一次。我哋啲同事咧，有啲同事係會收到啲滋擾性嘅電話啦。咁就係大量嘅，咁啊亦都係有啲咧係會收到一啲恐嚇性嘅字句啦。咁就舉例就可能會話知佢住喺邊度，咁就會上去殺咗佢咁樣。佢屋企人亦都會收到同樣嘅呢啲咁嘅信息啦，係啦咁樣。
阿 Sir， 你
有
冇有個防
潛效應嗰個可以答埋先？
好，我唔係好明你嗰個，因為
即
係
意思
就
係而家好多人都會喺網上討論嘅，咁係咪即係要接觸到啲乜嘢嘅程度先係涉及？
我想咧，網上或者係現實世界咧，言論自由咧係得到好大嘅保障。但係無論喺現實世界或者網絡世界裏面咧，如果我哋係講一啲説話係而帶有呢個刑事嘅成分嘅時候，去舉例去恐嚇其他人嘅咧，都一樣係會觸犯法例嘅。
阿 Sir， 我問你，我仲有一條問題，阿 Sir， 我仲有一條問題，而家。